Welcome to this video lecture series on engineering mechanics. In the previous videos, we have gone through what is triangle law and we have gone through what it has been used. Now, in this video, we are going to go through its application, means where it is used. So, we are going to go for finding out a resultant using triangle law. Now, when we talk about triangle law or parallelogram law, these are the laws that we can use to find out resultant, but there is a criteria for that. The force system should be a two force system, and there are some other methods also to find out resultant, like resolution method and even polygon law, which is a graphical method. Now we'll just check out how to solve or how to determine a resultant in its magnitude and direction using triangle law. So the statement goes like this: determine the resultant in its magnitude and direction using triangle law. And this is the given force system. This is a concurrent force system where two forces are acting, one in first quadrant, other in second quadrant, making an angle of 40 degrees and 30 degrees respectively. The magnitude of two forces are 10 newton and 6 newton respectively. Now to find out its resultant in its magnitude and direction, what we have to do is, we have to start with imaginary origin. We have to consider a particular point as origin, and then from that particular point we have to apply the logic of triangle law, that what we have learned in triangle law. So this is what we are going to apply here. So according to triangle law, what we have to do is start with any one of the two forces. So you can either start with 6 kilonewton, you can 6 newton, or you can either start with 10 newton. So in this case, we'll go with 10 newton force. So what we are doing is, here the 10 newton force, it acts along first quadrant, making an angle of 40 degrees. So similarly, what you are doing is, here you have to draw the same force here from this point. So now this is how it is moving. Its value is 10 newton, making an angle of 40 degrees. So now while doing so, you should be having a imaginary scale also in your mind. Now triangle law, you can also go with a graphical approach. Here we are going to go with an analytical approach. When you are going for a graphical approach, you have to set a particular scale. Means, for example, 1 centimeter is equal to 1 newton and likewise. So if we are going through a graphical approach, on a graph paper you have to start with a particular point that you have to consider as origin. Then take protractor, draw a line, and on that line mark if our scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 1 newton. If you are taking this as your scale, then on this line which is making an angle of 40 degrees, as the unit of this particular or magnitude of this particular force is 10 newton and our scale is 1 centimeter is equal to 1 newton, by using the scale you have to measure 10 centimeters and you have to mark. But here, as we are going through analytical approach, approximately we have to have the scale in mind so that we can differentiate between the two magnitudes of the two different forces that we have, that is 10 and 6. So if we assume this is a 10 newton force and if this is the end point of this particular 10 newton force, now according to triangle law, what I do is that at the end point of the first force, we have to draw again a imaginary quadrant system or an imaginary origin point, and then from this we have to go with the next force. So the next force is 6 newton force, making an angle of 30 degrees and which is acting along second quadrant. So now here draw a line which is moving in second quadrant, approximately making an angle of 30 degrees, and then we'll assume that this is the end point of the 6 newton force. So if you check out an approximate scale we have used, if this is 10, then somewhat around half of that will be 6 newton force. So now this is the end point of 6 newton force. Now this is our end point, this is our starting point. Now the line joining the starting point with the end point gives you the resultant, while the direction of that should be towards the end point. So now according to this, This resultant that you have got is moving in first quadrant. If by mistake you show an opposite direction, then it gives that the resultant is moving in third quadrant. So you get a wrong answer, wrong direction. So keep in mind, while joining the starting point and end point, the direction should be towards the end point. That will give the correct direction of resultant. Now once you have done this, if you have done this graphically, then you can directly get the magnitude of resultant using scale. How? So this is how you have drawn using scale 10 cm. Similarly, what you have to graphically draw a line making angle of 30 degrees on this measure 6 newton. Then if this whole thing you are done graphically, directly take scale from here to here, measure it. If this is something around 10 newton, then R is equal to 10 newton. If you are getting this distance as 9 cm, then R is 9 newton. Now to get the theta, that is direction, directly take protractor and check out this angle theta, you will be getting your resultant direction with respect to x-axis. But here we are not following that, we are going to solve using analytical method. So for this, now if you check out, we have converted this into a triangle having 3 sides. So for this, we'll use cosine rules. You can also use sine rule. So in this case, we'll use cosine rule. So for that, I will just nomenclature the points. This as A point, this as B point, and this as C point. Now to find out this R, I'm going to use cosine rule here. So I'll apply it for one of the points. So cos of B I will go with. So I'm taking this angle into consideration. So cos of B will be equal to, now I hope that you all know what is cosine rule, but still just we'll revise it. So cos of B, as we have taken B point, first of all we'll find out this total angle. So if this is 30, if this is 40, this will be also 40 degrees. So the total angle will be 30 plus 40, 70 degrees. So cos of B, here B is 70 degrees. Then we have to apply the cosine rule for this. So this B angle, it is the angle between 6 and 10 newton force. So here it will be 10 square plus 6 square minus, the opposite side for this B is R, minus R square divided by 2 into 10 into 6. These are the two adjacent sides which are making this angle. So 10 into 6. Now solving this, you will be getting resultant as 9.74 newton. So we have got our resultant in its magnitude. Now we have to find out the resultant in its direction. Now to find out its direction, actually we want this theta. But now we know what is this. This is 40 degrees. So if we will get this angle, that is angle A, as this is A point, we will consider this as angle A. If we get this A angle, this plus 40, you will be getting our required direction of the resultant. So for that, we will apply the cosine rule for A point. So we are getting cos of A equal to, now this A angle is made by these two sides R and 10. So the formula will be R square plus 10 square minus, the opposite side is 6. So 6 square divided by, these are the two sides which are making the angle A, so 2 into R into 10. Now in this formula, R we have already calculated 9.74, A we know, A is what we have to find out. So by solving, we are getting A as 35.35 degrees. But this is not our required determination. Our aim is to find out the direction of resultant with respect to x-axis. So this theta will be A plus 40 degrees. So A is 35.35, so you're getting theta is 75.35 degrees. So this is our second determination, that is the direction. Now we'll represent this resultant in its magnitude and direction graphically. So now we have replaced this two force system into a single force system. So this is R. According to this, it is moving in first quadrant. So its value is 9.74 newton, and theta what we have got is 75.35 degrees. So this is how we have got resultant in its magnitude and direction by using triangle law. We can also verify the answer by using parallelogram for this particular force system, and even we can verify the answer using resolution method. I hope that you all have understood this particular numerical. Thanks for watching the video.